Behind the Bunker is brought to you by Empire Paintball, Arup's Bunker Systems, Dye Paintball, Tittman Sports, and Flag Raiders Paintball.
Okay, guys, welcome to the after show. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for all the guys in the chat. Joe, I'm going to finish this message here. What do you have
to talk about?
Yeah, anything interesting?
Just that we hosted Canadian Carnage. I need to get rid of my paperwork. We hosted Canadian Carnage on the weekend. It was put together by Viper Scenarios. Anyone that doesn't know, you can check out his Facebook page, Viper Paintball. Anyway, he travels around North America. I think he does one or two Canadian stops, and this was his Canadian stop last year. His first one was again last year, and this year we hosted it. It's put on by Underground Products, the Northern Gunmen, and we had a pretty good time. Lots of paint was shot. People liked the field. We had some bacon-inspired food items.
There was more bacon on the field I've ever seen before.
Lots of bacon. Bacon burgers, bacon on a bun.
Canadian bacon. Key meal bacon.
All kinds of bacon. Yeah. Bacon-flavored cupcakes, all kinds of stuff.
For sure.
Bacon wraps. So it was good.
So guys,
everyone had a good time. The weather was good, and Todd wants to talk, so here you go.
No, I was just going to, just for those of you guys that are tuning in the after show, basically, we are not playing any videos tonight. It's just basically us answering your questions, as well as the ones on the chat forum, as well as just us to be able to stretch our legs and banter. A lot of you have been requesting a podcast version of this show, so we're going to start developing it here on the after show. And
Todd can talk about the compressor's hazard. He knows more about them than I do. I just know we had good air.
Yeah, we did have good air. I will apologize to all the people who attended my field on the weekend. We did let the air drop down to 4,650 PSI was the lowest we dropped down to. So
yeah,
I apologize
terrible,
for
Todd.
Those of you. And I also
terrible.
Apologize to all those people who complained that they were getting almost 4,000 or 5,000 PSI fills. Next time we'll have to make sure that we don't give you as much. When Seb gets back, Seb is getting freshening up. When he gets back, we have lots of your questions to get to. If there's anything that you guys need to get to, Matt's got the questions. If there's anything that you guys want to ask, let us know. Now, Danger Man, I see you in the chat. We are not getting your video tonight. We just ran out of time, but I want to play that next week. Guys, you need to stay tuned. Danger Man sent me a great video of him training to how to catch a paintball. It sounds a lot easier than it is. And you'll see why he was having some difficult time with it. So stay tuned for that.
Can I make a comment to Kitty? Kitty, if you're still watching, Justin Bieber's from Stratford, and our field is about 25 minutes from where he lives when he's in Canada. If you know him and have contact with him, since he has all this great paintball stuff, if he would like to come out midweek to our field, I can certainly arrange for a private game where he and his friends or whatever can go play paintball uninterrupted, unhounded, unpressured, and just have a good old time playing paintball. So we can arrange that to happen, and certainly can be done. So
for sure. So why don't we move on? Alabaster Slim is asking to see the new Velkin logo. I do not have that, nor have I seen it yet. If I have it, I will definitely let you guys know. Same with SR Shea 138. I don't have it, guys. We will, as soon as I see it, I will go. Maybe Matt will make something out of crayons and we'll show it at the end of the after show. Seb, Matt, you guys have some questions. Let's get the party started.
Hello.
Oh, and this is a Podstein, by the way.
A Podstein.
Done by Barney last year at D-Day. Awesome.
Very cool.
Thank you again, Barney.
So outside of paintball field, if you could play anywhere, where would you like to play and why? AKA, let's say, a subway, a cruise ship, or just your local city center.
I think the question should read, how can Seb make the best question I've ever had sent into the show sound any more dull? Come on, Seb, it should have been, hey, guys.
Hey, guys, I got a great question.
I would have read it the same way.
Thank you, Matt.
Thank you. I guess. So the question.
That's because, Matt, you're just so full of bacon from the weekend.
Yeah.
So the question is, if we could play paintball anywhere in the world, if we were allowed to do so, where would we go? We can certainly start chatting about that. One thing I will say off the top of my head is Joe and I talked about this a while ago about some of Shoreline Paintball's venues and how, You know, last year they attacked an island in a small island in Croatia via Zambonis. That was
Zodiacs. Cool. Zambonis go on hockey rinks.
Well, yes, but it was in the middle of winter, and the Adriatic Sea was frozen over, so they needed they needed that. I don't know.
No marker.
No.
I saw the new Vulcan logo. I'm gonna draw it.
Oh yeah, very good. So, I don't know. Where would you guys like to play? Disney would be cool.
It's a little Mickey Mouse for my liking.
Notice how I spoon-fed that? Yes. But no, it was... I don't know. New York City would be cool. There's lots of venues down there.
I would like to play
Seattle,
on
Seattle. And I say that because they have the Underground City, which you ever go to Seattle, do not take that tour. It is the biggest scam in the entire world, the Underground City. Joe and I got talked into that while we were in Seattle 2 years ago for a friend's wedding, and the Underground City consisted of a basement of two buildings, I believe.
It wasn't very good.
It was horrible. Suey, what about you?
There's a really cool place we went to. I believe it's in Penetanguishene. It was called Discovery Harbor. Like, it's all set up like pirate ships, and there's all these old buildings, like as if it was, you know, the 18th century and all that during the British invasion of North America and all that jazz. And it was, and I looked around and it was really cool because all the forts were still there and all the big cannons were there, and it just. I thought it would be awesome. There's also one in Belleville, which is the old fort. It was the old Fort Henry, I believe that's there.
Yep.
And it's like the same way. It's that old.
Danger Man had a great one.
Really cool.
The White House, Colonel Mustard, Legoland.
Legoland.
I think those
yes.
are cool.
Well, they spelled Lego with one G. I don't know if that's the way they spelled America.
Voyagin says Abandoned City in Chernobyl.
That's glowing.
That'd be great, except for the cancer.
I have the best one.
Okay.
The Playboy Mansion.
Yes, that would be cool. I also thought The Rock.
I have a couple thoughts.
Like okay. Alcatraz? Yeah,
I would like to play on a cruise ship. I would also like to play at the MGM Grand or the Bellagio. That would be just awesome.
Why not just the whole strip?
Well, you don't need the whole strip. You could do a big attack and defend on Caesar's Palace would be cool. Those things are magnificent.
An actual airplane, like at an airport, that'd be cool if you're trying to get a hostage rescue off an airplane.
or at the Louvre in France.
The Louvre, yeah. The mission is to capture the Mona Lisa.
Repaint the Mona Lisa.
Make your own painting.
I don't know. We're watching the chat form right now to see
what
you guys...
Right down the strip in Mogadishu, right there. Right
well, since we're talking about France, why not do the old Normandy?
Normandy beaches are still some.
You know what? I was just going to say what a cop out that is, but you know what? That's really isn't
Shoreline,
that would be cool.
Isn't Shoreline doing that this year?
I'm sure
they got the old like 15th century fort and all that stuff. Because there's four different events this summer, right? I believe one of them is part of the old trench system from World War II.
You know what
kind of
be cool too is like an abandoned sports arena, like a hockey or a baseball arena, because that place just has. I mean, it has a big wide open bowl for where the sports happen, but think of all the staircases and the levels and stuff. That'd be pretty cool. How's your phone?
Area 51.
Area 51.
Chat room says Area 51.
Well, there's that airplane graveyard as well in Arizona or Nevada.
Yeah, for sure. I don't know. Certainly a lot of different things. Why don't we move on? You still guys got lots of questions. We could ramble about this all night. Someone's saying a cargo ship. That'd be pretty cool too.
That'd be cool.
Oh, did you find the new logo?
I drew it all up.
Oh, can we have a close-up? This is the new logo, according to Zuby.
Yep.
It's very nice.
Valcan.
Yep.
And they're going to change the...
It's because it's been bought by Val Kilmer. So they actually just changed the name in the logo. It's kind of reminiscent of Batman.
Very nice. All right, hit us up with another question.
Maybe. I
don't really know. Seb here gave me the honor of asking the next one. This is from Mike H. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that. It's a combination question. What is your favorite marker? What do you think is the best marker? What do you think is the worst marker?
Ooh.
A lot of questions.
Best marker first.
Well, best speedball, best scenario, best
marker. What is your? If you had any choice of marker, we'll take liberties with this question. If you had to choose one marker to play with,
how do you do that?
Honestly, this may be a cop-out, but I'll go first. My Empire Sniper. I've been a pump player for a long time. That would be the one gun that I would play with. Now, obviously, I wouldn't be able to play much speedball with it, but again, that's the gun that I choose most often than not. Zuby, your favorite? What about you, Seb?
I would go with a DM12, but if I would like to pick the SAR-12, which I saw last weekend and I'm totally in love with, but I never shot the gun yet. But these two, I really, really like.
Matt?
I'm in the same vein as Seb. I've never shot a Nasty Typhoon, but that'd be very interesting. And I think aesthetically, and I think that's one of the best looking guns out there. Yeah.
I guess my choice is not very practical if we're talking about if we're going to play crossover, if we're going to play on both forums. But I don't know. I'll keep thinking. What do you think? Joe, what do you think?
I don't know. I like my TM15 until something comes up that's mag-fed and actually works. Then I may consider...
I suppose a TM15, you could play bow scenario and speedball if you had to. It has the ramping.
A mini, right?
Chris Hazard in the chat, Canadian Honey Badger, is giving you a hard time of my choice, but I stick with it.
Kitty likes a Stingray. Do you like the long barrel Stingray, Kitty, or the short barrel, the Stingray 2? What do you like? The black or the clear ones?
Eric Engler in the chat says he would like a minimalistic Phenom. Furby says his Vapor. We have some Assaults, some Phenoms. Interesting choices. We're getting it from all over. I'd be curious to see what Simon has to say. I know Simon has many guns and has been through many and shot many before.
He's probably not at liberty to discuss it, so we won't.
Okay, what was the next one? Not the best gun. What was the second one?
The worst gun.
There was a third one in there as well.
You know what? I'm gonna ruffle someone's feathers on this, but I think the Evil Omen has got to be the worst gun that I've ever. And that's only because I've had one and I understand why it was. What do you guys say?
Some of those Brass Eagle things.
The Marauders?
The Plaster.
Like the back even that, not the Cobras, but the Barracudas, those first generation semi-automatic blasphemy clunky vibrating pieces of shit. Those things.
Yeah.
Just came flying out of there.
Brass Eagle had a couple guns that looked like pressure washer.
Yeah, like that's like you're talking Barracuda and
the
all.
Plastic one?
You're taking.
I thought that was a Zap gun. The plastic ones? I thought those were Zap.
No, this predates those.
You guys are taking a lot of sales from Kmart right now. This is.
Yeah, the chat room exactly just said that as he's.
Yeah, Gladiator 2. Yeah. All right, and what was the third part of that question?
It was a combination of the first. Well, basically, you touched on it. It's favorite marker and best marker.
You know, okay, we can answer that. What is the best marker of all time? I'm going to have a cop-out on this one, but I believe it's probably true. And we talked about this about a month ago. I think the Tippmann Model 98, not my choice of gun to shoot, but if it without the Tippmann Model 98, that literally revolutionized the field rental gun.
Same could be said about the Ion.
Yes.
Not so much as a field gun, but as in bringing the electro market into the hands of everyone, basically.
Yeah.
Sheridan rifle, Piranha long barrel, PMI 1, those are all... Those were the stepping stone from a Nelspot 007 to the next generation of pump markers. When the PGP got a pump on it, then they came out with the PMI 1 or the PMI long barrel. That stuff started. That's when paintball came into its own.
Yeah. Love that you guys are in the chat forum talking to us. Someone's saying Spider for being one of the worst guns. I know we're back on this. JT Splatmaster, where do you rank that? Is that one of the best design guns or one of the best concepts for a gun to get new kids into the sport, or is that a whole other conversation?
I think it's another conversation. I know what the concept of the whole Splatmaster program is, but I don't know if it's being welcomed, if it's people are accepting or embracing it, I guess is the proper word. I know how they're marketing it. I think the idea, the concept is good, but I just don't know how it's being embraced.
Yeah. Now we should touch on this at some other point, but 50 cal paintball, is that something that we should be embracing as the paintball industry? Is it worth it, or is that something that should just be swept under the rug and left alone? That's a conversation as well.
If you look at 50 cal, you have to have something that's going to sweep everyone off their
68 caliber feet.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, really, like, what do we have right now? We've got a couple of pistols. Oh, great, they're pistols. But that's not going to put it in the hands of somebody who's going to show up to the field and play every weekend. You've got to show me a new technology that makes it better than 68 that's going to convince me to go out to the field.
Yeah. Cupcake in the chat forum is agreeing with me about the Tippmann Model 98, but he's also a field owner, so or an operator, so he respects that. Simon did answer my question. His favorite gun of all time is the Bell Sales Evolution X. So I thought maybe he'd be on the Evil Omen kick, but I guess not. So
you know, secretly, he's got a couple of them unopened in his house waiting.
Maybe so.
Vault.
Maybe so.
5 years from now.
Guys, we're watching the chat. It's zipping by right now. We're trying to concentrate on it. If there's any questions or anything that you want us to chat about, pop it up or send me a private message. I'm Todd on the chat. Surprise, surprise. I'll be hard to find. I'm the only guy in there that's red. Matt and Seb. Zuby's beside me. What do we have for questions?
Oh, yeah, you have them. Just to clarify, Simon, I'm not glorifying the Ion in any way. I was referring to what Todd was saying in the form of revolutionary.
All right. Thanks, Simon. Matt finally speaks up. And not only that, he vocalizes his opinion and you're shutting him down, Simon. This is the first and last time that Matt's going to get on the mic.
I got a good one. Okay. Hey, I have a good question for you, Todd.
Hey, Rod Roddy's
back. How about that?
And we're out of time.
I'll tell you what. This question from Matt Stimler. When the instruction says rinse and repeat, how many times are you supposed to repeat? Question mark.
That might be have to be answered on our after show. Do we have any other tangible questions? Maybe not so excitable ones?
From another question from Diego. Can you spray a paintball gun? If so, where can you and can you not paint the gun?
That's a great question. Before we get to that, Mustard sent me a message and wants to know, Zuby, do you like your resurrection as much as he does? Oh, we're going to have to bleep that one out.
Zuby's resurrection's in my store. I'm just holding it for him until he can use it.
Yeah. A-Train in the chat, I'm going to let you answer this. This question comes from someone in that sent me a private message. He says, can you take off the bonnet from a CO2 tank and replace it with an HPA reg?
No.
A-Train, go. Simple answer, no. But he'll explain that for you. Sorry, what was the question again? I went off on a bit of a tangent.
I do believe the question was, where can you paint the marker and where should you not paint it?
Depends on the marker, right? I mean, if you
something as simple as if you wanted to paint a Tippmann 98, and if you take it apart and split the clamshell, take the barrel out, but you still have, there's a lot of movement between the bolt, the hammer, the linkage arm, the trigger. You have to be cautious of all those areas. If you're going to paint something, strip it down. You can use oven cleaner. That'll take a lot of the paint off. You can sand it down. You can sandblast it. But then anywhere where there's movement of any parts or components where the tolerances are very tight for like nuts and bolts, you want to be cautious of. You can tape those off, put hot glue in there and peel it out when you're finished. But anything like that, then paint away.
Yeah, for sure. Anything that goes inside your gun or has an access to get inside, whether it's the side cock on a Model 98, the end of your barrel or your breech or where your feed neck goes in, I would highly recommend not putting any paint in there. So old school autocockers, nothing on the front where the three-way and the LPR is. I would keep paint away from any trigger assembly, especially on electronic guns. Paint gets in there, it might make the trigger sticky or not travel smoothly between the tolerances there. I also had another question here that came in. This one through the chat, Shaggy wants to know, with the release of the Empire autococker, do you think this will lead other companies to make new autocockers, new pumps, and maybe even automags again? So he's wondering if
Planet Eclipse will start making accessories for autocockers again.
No, but his question, I know where you were going with that, but his question basically is asking if some of the old retro style guns are going to be making a comeback. The autococker, I believe, is still a tangible, viable marker. I think the automag is still...
I was going to say, with the exception of the automag, what's worth bringing back?
Lapco is apparently producing some bodies for Cockers.
Yeah, the spiral. What do they call it? Spiral body?
I think so.
Yeah. Is that what? Yeah, spiral body.
We have another question. I apologize, dude. I can't pronounce your name. Abo is his first. It says, "What would you ever play paintball in the Middle East?" Michael. Sorry. To be honest with you, I've never been to the Middle East. I don't have plans to go there, and with my lack of knowledge of where to go and where is safe over there, I would probably say no. If I had an invitation from someone who was very credible and was going to take me somewhere safe that I trusted, sure, I'd almost go anywhere. But
apparently there's some sheikhs in Dubai that have built in huge indoor play areas that are air-conditioned. If someone invited me to Dubai to go play paintball at an indoor air-conditioned place, that would be awesome.
Yeah, someone in the chat
forum.
I'll go
for a case of muffin tops.
Someone in the chat forum named Hoorah just said that he doesn't think that other companies are going to invest in making pumps, and I think agree with him. I think where we have and what we have right now, I don't know if you'd want to compete with that. That was Wolf in the chat.
Simon, I talked to Tom K about doing mags. You better not be pulling my chain.
The table, you can't see this at home,
likely, but may happen.
But the table in front of Zuby is starting to raise up a little bit, and we need to change the topic, or else Zuby's not going to be able to leave the studio for a while.
Lapco released the Grey Ghost, yes. They started at Extravaganza.
That was a few years ago, wasn't it?
Oh, they brought out another
they
one.
They remade it.
Yeah, Wolf says there is a great paintball field in Kuwait.
Better Kuwait like than never.
I think live is better than the video.
Yeah. All right. Do we have any more questions to get to? I got to be honest with you guys. I'm enjoying the after show. This is fun for us to stretch our legs and chat with you guys with all the chat that's going on. And I also enjoy these questions. So keep them coming in. And if the after show goes well, then despite the fact that Hawaii 5-0 starts again soon, we might go a little bit longer.
Oh, boy.
Hawaii 5-0. Come on. All right, what else do we have?
All right, this is a bit of a statement question, but from Dave Key. And he writes, does our sport really need girls going around in skimpy outfits or bikini contests, etc.? Is this the best way to promote paintball if we want to attract more women and families? What do you think?
You know what? Paintball is a male-dominated sport, and I mean, it depends on the venue. I mean, if you have a family-friendly event that you want to promote, then maybe I would say no. But if you're promoting, you know, a guy's weekend, and I mean, let's face it, 90, what would you say the percentage of male to females are in paintball?
About 90%, 92% male, 8% female. Look at NASCAR. It's predominantly, look how they market. NASCAR does, it's predominantly male, but there's lots of families that go watch NASCAR races, and they're a marketing machine.
Yeah. I mean, in our local newspaper, you open up I haven't bought them in years, but you used to be able to open the first page, and on the inside cover was what was called the Sunshine Girl. It was a girl scantily clad in a bikini, and that was on full color. The paper was not all in full color, but that one sure as heck was. And I mean, whether you like it, you know, whether you like that representation or not, unfortunately, it's something you can't escape, and it's.
It's family reading,
and they were not, or
mass reading for that matter.
Yeah, so I don't know, and I mean, most of the big games and scenarios that you go to aren't necessarily mass marketed to the families to bring out. They're mass marketed to guys who want to get into character, get into costume, and play these all day long war themed scenario games. Otherwise, they wouldn't be themed like that. So I don't know. That's a pretty tough discussion.
There were Several girls at Carnage, several playing. But if you look at the evolution of speedball, for example, 5 or 6 years ago, when speedball started or was coming into its own, it was just predominantly guys. But as the sport gained recognition and got bigger and stronger and became more legitimate, then families started to come and watch their kids, boyfriends play. Girls, there's a lot more girls. If you go to any recognized event, there's tons of girls wandering around with their boyfriends, lots of families, lots of mothers, fathers, because they booked their vacation time around these events. So as much as speedball
I balk at it and make fun of it. There is a huge amount of family involvement, and there are a lot of girls around speedball fields. Yep. Conversely, as recreational paintball starts to take off, and you see more of these scenario games and big games, there's a lot more families around, a lot more girls around.
Yeah, for sure. First of all, Chris Hazard, the Canadian Honey Badger, has been trolling me all evening, but I'm not at liberty to say what he's making fun of me about. Needless to say, he seems to think I look like a small wooded woolly creature. Carlos is asking, how do I like my E-flexes? Have you had a chance to wear the E-flexes?
The E-flexes, I've tried on a couple of times. They don't exactly fit my face, so I never really had any interest in
them. Most goggles aren't designed for beards, though.
No. I stick with my tried, tested, and true ProFlex, and I probably will until they stop making them.
Yeah.
I wear an E-flex.
Yeah. I've been wearing JT goggles for a long, long time, and I've tried the E-flex. I have my own pair. I enjoy them. Yeah, for sure. For sure. And they're big. Like, I've got an odd looking and shaped face, so it does fit okay, and it's a little oversized, so I don't mind that. Seb, what about yourself? What do you wear? Oh, thanks for the close up on that one. Yes, there you can see how deranged and yeah. What about you, Seb?
Events.
Yes, we're talking about events?
Yes.
Do you wear them?
Yes.
What do you think of them?
I like them, but I also like the padding of the
take your time. We're only on a half hour show here, so it's fine.
Yes, I have an oven mitt.
Muffin top foam. I wish I could like Frankenstein, like all companies.
I didn't realize Frankenstein was German. Sorry,
Frankenstein. It's by Walter Matthau accent.
Where's he from? Romania? No, Liechtenstein. Where's Frankenstein? What is that?
Transylvania.
Transylvania.
I thought that was Dracula.
Oh, it's Dracula.
Yeah, it's his cousin.
Yeah. Oh, brilliant question. Can I interject with this?
Yeah.
Off the Twitter feed, off the break, asks. I think this is great. Do you guys think that each paintball field has a specific smell, or do all paintball fields smell the same? That is a brilliant question. And I say that because, you know, let's talk about three or four different paint companies. They all have similar but different fills. I would say that a field that shoots one versus the other, there would definitely be a smell. I know if you have a field that has a large speedball proponent, the paint stagnates on the ground, gets wet, and then leaches into the ground and has a specific pungent odor. That smell for me in my area is recognizable when I go to different fields or events. But maybe it's different. Maybe because we're sharing similar paint manufacturers in our area, maybe it's similar.
And the smells have changed in the last couple of years because the fills of the paint have changed unofficially in the last couple of years. It's gone back to a water-based peg when two or three years ago, there was a lot of oils and fish oils used in the fill, and you can tell that by the elastics on your BBD and the elastics on your goggle straps weren't lasting as long, and they were breaking down and getting sticky. That's because of the fills unofficially.
I think next week, Seb, we're gonna have to put you on the chat. People keep sending me private messages, which are great, but I'm having a hard time keeping up, and they're great questions, so we're missing some of them. We're gonna have to do that for next week.
Sounds good.
So next week we'll make you the question guy, and that way you can moderate those. Because as I say, I'm missing a bunch of them, and some of them are really good.
What about Dusty?
Dusty could do that too. He's a little bit tired there still. How do you think aircraft in paintball would affect it? Would you like to see a helicopter mounted marker? You know, that's a great question. I saw a lot of arguments on Facebook last couple weeks about there was an event that was showing a helicopter that was shooting paintballs out of it. During a live game, you know, they were arguing whether it's safe or not.
I'd like to take this time just to interrupt you for a couple of seconds and talk about this effect called rotor wash. Trust me when I say this. When you shoot from the door of a helicopter underneath the helicopter, you're not hitting what you're aiming at.
What if you break it down, though? What if you get a high-powered drone, like a relatively strong drone that could handle a smaller marker?
You're still going to get rotor wash.
Not from a drone.
He said high-powered drone.
Well, something that can carry maybe like a TPX or something, like a light pistol.
I could see,
like
but...
You need like an invert mini with like some sort of
Something. I'm no engineer, but
I don't either. Ask Simon.
But yeah, I just
get Simon in on this.
Like I was always say, like when you get to scenario paintball, when is too much muchness, right? Like like this past weekend we had first strike rounds. You've got regular paintball markers. You've got rockets. You've got grenades. You had sniper rounds. You had all this, and when does it become, a simulation as opposed to playing paintball? I mean, yeah, what's next? You had drones. Okay, we had RC car tanks with, paint grenades on them.
With sound effects.
Yeah, when does it become not playing paintball and just worried about then whatever else cranes. Can kill you underneath the ground and in the air and cranes and...
Paintball slowly just nerf. Emulating the modern warfare.
Yeah. I want to go and play paintball on my weekends. I don't want to play nerf. Drone, helicopter, underground, subterranean, paintball market.
I have a question for Todd, actually.
Okay.
Todd, have you ever played on the old practice arena for the Mavericks near past Stratford?
To be honest with you, I never once got in that facility.
I've been there a few times, and they had this humongous fan at the top of the arena.
Look where they are now.
And, like... You would shoot straight, and these suckers would get sucked right up because of these humongous blades spinning around.
Was it not a hockey arena or something?
It was like a hockey arena, yeah. Yeah, that was...
What it takes.
Chris Hazard has a question, but I think we're running out of time, so we might not be able to answer that. The question goes, Dustin, Seb, and Zuby. sleep with one, marry one, and kill one. Go. Why don't we answer that question next time?
On Behind a Bunker.
Dustin is on the... thanks for the troll again, Chris Hazard. Oh, he just doesn't give up. All right. Do we have any more questions or should we end the after show? We are getting the signal that Matt's giving the wristwatch symbol, which indicates that we're...
Good seeing you on Saturday, Wolf.
Joe's leg started shaking, so Hawaii 5.
As I say, guys,
soon.
If you get an opportunity, hit me up on Facebook. Let me know if you are enjoying the after show or not, or if it's a painful paint drying thing and you're not interested. I would like to know, and we're going to, as I say, if it's something that you guys are enjoying, we will extend it and put more effort into the after show. As I say, we'll have some moderators to moderate all your questions, and we'll try to get to them as much as we can. If you don't think it's good, send me a message and we won't waste your time. Don't forget, guys, to subscribe to YouTube. All of our great stuff is going up there. Look for a new website. Something big coming to Behind the Bunker in the next couple of weeks. We're going to be looking for some new correspondence for some new projects we're working on. So if you're interested and have some time, let us know. And I will do my best. I know I've offended a lot of you out there that I will sit in a makeup chair next week and ensure that the complexion on my face matches from the top of my forehead to the bottom of my chin. You can't even tell. Can you see that's like lobster skin?
Just go out tanning with a balaclava on.
Your neck looks like Jean-Luc's neck.
I tell you. And the studio lights don't help, that's for sure. Anything you guys want to say before we sign out?
No, watch us next week. Yeah. Watch us in your eye. Tell your friends. Watching.
Yeah. What was I going to say? Thanks to the guys in the booth. Thanks for Matt for speaking his mind this week. And you know what? Don't let Simon pick on you. He's a
Simon
bully.
Simon rattled me.
Paintball bully.
He's a bully, and he has a British accent. And
prophecies he too loaded will revolutionize.
The only argument he really will boil down to is he will tell you that his opinion is revolutionary. Yes. And Seb, thank you for being in the show tonight. Thank you for putting up with our...
You're welcome. I'd like to point something out, actually, before we end the show.
Oh, we don't have
time. The screen's been blocking my shirt, but this shirt's been pointing at Todd all night.
Tosser.
Tosser. That's great. Great, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Again, send us your feedback. Either show at behindthebunker.com or post on Facebook. That's great. Thank you for watching, guys. We will see you next week for the pre and after show. Wow, chicka wow. See you next week.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit subscribe and click the links below to watch some more videos from Behind the Bunker.